Good evening, everyone. My name is Heath Haskins, Code Primate, and this is Lumber Tycoon 2. With Code Primate, my main character, building on his laboratory. What's up? All right, so last time we left off, we had Bob Cool help us out with the last part here, and he said, go up one more level. So that's what we did. Only I only wanted to go up like half a level. So we took the, these blueprints here, and we basically went rotate, turn, put them on their sides, and then went across the top like that. So I still have plenty of work to do. I want to get a roof on this and get the start to the second floor. And I've already started moving in some logic, but I want a lot more than just this. So I'm going to have AND switches and OR switches and XOR switches and inverters and all kinds of good stuff. I'm going to teach you guys how to use all the different logic, which there are already tutorials out there on it, but I like playing with the logic more than anything. And like, I come up with weird things like this. Hold on. Like where I was trying to put wire through the doors of the truck and it ended up lifting it off the ground, which is amazing. Hold on. Let's go ahead and get this down. Move. And it's not going to register until I place. Boom. There we go. So that was kind of fun. In fact, I'm just going to go ahead and do that real quick because I want to do it again. Oh, gosh. What I was trying to do is I was trying to see if I could attach the wire to the lights to try and turn on the lights, and it wasn't working. So I'll just demonstrate that real quick. One, two, three, and four. So it's attached to the headlight, which I thought, yeah, that might work. It doesn't. So the next thought was, well, what if it was somewhere inside that it has to be attached? Finished. So I'll show you that. I'm basically walking you through what I did, and it's kind of cool. So when I pulled it up here like this, I was like, this was open as well. Oops, that's my XL. Hold on. Let's grab that one. Move. And we have a little bit of lag, but I think that might be my internet provider. That's not like my speeds. So then I was like, let's attach it to the wheel. Boom, like that. And that didn't work. New. So what if we attach it to the seat, because the seat is technically what controls the lights, because you get welded to the seat, but it's using a player detect script. So I doubt this is going to work, but just for fun. Finished. So now we're attached to the seat. We're gonna give it a signal. No lights, no nothing. Nope. So that's when I got the idea. What if I were to move it across the whole thing and then close the doors on it? So we'll go here, here, and then on the inside, right here. So it would go through the window. Oh, that's actually through the door. Hold on. B. Let's go through right there. Yeah, so that will go through the window. Attach it to the inside right here. And then just down to the floor, or maybe to the door handle there. If we do it right there, finished. So that would basically lock in a car in place, right? I was thinking, oh, there's a way that we could like strap down the pink cars so they don't glitch out. Yeah. So this is what happens when you shut the doors. Oh goodness. It went crazy. And that's how you left a truck. So. Yeah, have fun with that. And let's get to building. We will have more experiments soon. A lot more. Because the laboratory is like, oh, it's awesome. It's amazing. We are going to use regular floors now. So let's just do floors. Large floor. Which I guess I could just use large tiles, right? Hold on. Should we use tiles? Or should we use floors? Let's use floors. It might take a little bit more wood, but it's going to be a little bit more solid as well. So, turn. And did I leave any room? I left no room, did I? Oh, darn. I left no room to build like a sign on the outside or anything. That's my mistake. That's okay. Right about there. That looks good. Maybe. Is it even on that side? Yeah. Even on this side. Excellent. I'm going to turn the music up a little. Nope, no, I'm not. I'm going to leave the music right where it's at because it's beautiful and glorious. All right. Come on. Come on. Get up there. Get up there. Get up there. One more. Good. And good. Ooh, that didn't work. And good. Come on. One more. Beautiful. Okay. I think I'm going to want some stairs. So, we'll make some stairs right there. Let's just do this. Do this. One. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Two. And three. Oh. Oh, wait, 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 wait. I completely missed. All right, come here, you. So we got to move this. And it's going to go right here. Oh, right here, right here, right. Right there. Perfect. Now, I really should be building the tiles first, shouldn't I? Wait, how many units does this take? Uh, 35 units. And how many does a tile take? Doesn't say. Oops. B. 14. 35 versus 14. I think I should build tiles. That's how I feel. Let's go ahead and destroy the tiles. Destroy the tiles. Can't even destroy those. Okay, there we go. Destroyed. Oh gosh. Destroyed. 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 And destroyed. Good. Okay. So, these are all 2x2s, so I should be able to go 1 unit wide. 2 units wide. 3 about there. Might be there. Possibly. I'll go grab some more as well. We'll see if this works. Okay. Let's just put down a large tile right there. Why not? 72%. Oh gosh. Boom. There we go. Sweet. Move. And let's just place this one right here. There we go. That's about even. So that'll be my cornerstone. Yeah. We got lots of pine, courtesy of Bob. Cool. Bob the Builder. We need the wedges. Let's go to the wedges. And if we make, that's the steepest that we can make, right? If we do the 4x4s. 3x3s, 2x2s, 1x1s. 4x4 wedge. Because I don't want to do, like, normal stairs. I want to do a ramp. Turn like that. All right, hold on. Rotate. Good. And we're just going to set this one right here. That's right there on the edge. That's beautiful. 2, 3. Like that. Sweet. And how many units does it take? Oh, come here. It takes 18 units. So, 5, 10, 15 would be right about the middle. It's going to take 3 of these. So I've got 2 here. Oh gosh, it takes forever to cut. No. When you see people doing like speed builds and big builds and stuff like that. Oh gosh. Oh no. Okay, it took the whole thing. That's fine. We've got more. When you see people doing speed builds, this is what they're doing. Only a lot faster because they're time-lapsing. So. That's why I know when my username's this did the big fan art, that was a lot of time. And I thank him for it. It was amazing. Beautiful. Glorious. Okay. We got floors. Large tiles. Let's go ahead and just build right here. How many can I put right here? 2. Oh, what was that? What? I am building on my own structured land. I think it was a glitch. I don't know how many I need. I'm just kind of setting them down as fast as I can. That's good. Ooh. That looks amazing, actually. Okay, stop messing around. Let's go. Yep. 31%. Let's use up all this little stuff first. 87%. Oh, I feel it. I feel the lag. Do you feel it? There we go. Little piece of wood. Let's go. You're gonna become a floor. I'm a real boy. Little puppet made of wood. That's Pinocchio, by the way. But tonight we're just having a nice, easy build. Yes, I did jump into a private server. I'm not doing the 1 hour specials yet. Just kind of hanging out for tonight. Got in and went over and said hi in the Discord. Went over to Fissy Games. Got to talk to Fissy for a little bit, the new Fissy. And got to check out their Discord for a little bit. Hung out with those guys. Shout out to all the Discord over there as well. And then hung out in LT2 for a little bit. LT2 or Lumber Tycoon Discord. Lumber Chat. Which is awesome. Everyone's so amazing. Like you guys have done so much for me. I just like look, I'm sitting here on a base filled with presence and love and all over the place, and just that's you guys. You guys helped me and did this, and it's awesome. So quick announcement. I know that you guys love come here. What is that? Is that an actual tile? That's a tile. Oh no. What am I grabbing? Meh. I know that you guys love giving me presents and dropping things off for me and everything else like that, but the presents themselves, like the gifts and the ball and like all these things, they're great, but I usually don't use them too often. So something I would use is logic. If you want to give me the gift of logic, which should be attainable by everyone, and not just specialty items, I would enjoy those. So, if you don't have gifts, then, like, if you still want to give me a gift, I will take logic. I would love logic. Fill up the logic base. You don't have to. You can, you're more than welcome to, but you do not have to. You're not obligated to. You don't have to do it to like get a selfie. There's no price for it. And on a side note, there are other people walking around saying that they're me and they're not. So to let you know, there are three accounts that are truly me. Code Primate, the one that I'm on right now, that is the real me. Mr. Code Primate, Mr. Code Primate, that is the real me on Xbox. And Sam Per Life, that's it. Anybody claiming to be my brother or claiming to be my sister or my dad or any relations, with the exception of my kids who have their own names and have been announced like multiple times, don't believe them. All right. So, saw a video of people posing as me and signing my signature, which it turned out to be a funny video, but at the same time, like, they whitelisted that person. I'm like, oh, that's not me. Don't do that. No. So, on another note, there's every once in a while you will see me in a server and I won't be talking much. Either A, I'm talking on Discord, B, I'm recording, or C, I just recorded and I'm about to log out. There have been times I've just logged into a server and something happens and I gotta log back out or I get disconnected. So please don't be upset with me if you see me just flash into a server and flash back out, because that's, it happens sometimes. Nice and easy. So close. Oh no, it fell down again. Okay, let's just move that one in there like that. Good, 65%. We're getting really close. And I almost have all once. Yay. And boom. 67%. Oh, it's taking forever. Pleased to be building now. What I should do is like just get the big chunks out of the way and then TNT it. Of course, then I would probably lose gifts. That would not be good. Not good at all. Ouch. All these little pieces. The trucks. Just see the truck popped up on its side in the background. That's awesome. Alright, there's that. 72. Let's do that one. Oh, come here, you. Also, I think it's about time that we move the quad saw. What do you think? Leave me a comment down below. Say yes, move the quad saw, get rid of the quad saw, do something different, something new. It's a thought. Oh my gosh, I can't keep that on there. Okay. Let's grab another one like that. Here, that one will work. That'll finish it out. Boom. I'll grab this one. Boom. Like that. 31. I'm not going to use the whole thing. Not going to use the whole thing. Just only half. Half of it. Cut it in half, Code. Cut it in half. You got it. Wait, Code doesn't sound like that. You got it, Heath. That's the way Code talks. Coming out here in Lumberland. Taking on the volcano. Chopping the lumber, the trees, exploring the area. This is my home. This is Code's home. Code Primate Zone. Sorry, that's a commercial. Never mind. You're a big dork. I know. It's, by the way, you kind of get used to, like, talking to yourself. If you're planning on becoming a YouTuber, or if you've started YouTuber, or if there's any tips I can give you to becoming a YouTuber, that would be it. Just be really comfortable with talking to yourself and posting every day. Post on a daily basis, at least 15 to 30 minutes, at least once a week. So if you can't do the daily, do at least once a week. Make sure it's scheduled releases. on the same time, invest in a good microphone. All right, because if you go looking back at my first videos where I was using the Bluetooth headset thingy, well, it wasn't Bluetooth, it was a Plantronics answering service kind of phone, but it was, I thought it was fine because I didn't know any better. It was like, oh, man. Going back and listen to it now, I almost can't stand my own videos. Which I should do that. I should do a reaction video. Code reacts to his first video.
Okay, guys. Here we are. It's 2007. And I'm going to build some Second Life objects.
Nice.
Oh, no. 98. 99. Boop.
There it went. Sweet. Grab this one. Come on, you. Perfect. We got one more to do. One more. It's a big to-do.
Oh, by the way, if you can't see it, my shirt says Goonies.
If you are of the Goonies generation, hashtag Goonies never say die down below. If you're not of the Goonies generation, please, please go watch it. It is amazing. Yes, it's a little bit older movie, and yes, it has the horrible, horrible graphics. Like, you guys are going to be like, wait, it's not in HD. It's okay. It's not in widescreen either. But that would be a cool game to create on Roblox. The Goonies. Turn. There we go. Did that work? That worked, didn't it? Dude, sweet. Why can't the build over on the tree lands, or not tree lands, the tree house on Sam be that easy? I mean, that's going in there perfect. I'm not even having to, like, I hate to talk bad about the Sam for Life build, but it was going very slowly. This one doesn't seem to be giving me much problems, which is awesome. Oh, there, it's giving me problems. What's your problem? Okay, let's go in.
What is your issue, sir?
What? Always. Always one that messes it up. Then I gotta figure out how to get it in there. Oh, hold on. Did that go? Nope. Hold on. That worked for a second. Come on. Oh. Sweet. Sweet. So that's working out awesome. How much time? Okay, we're working on our last 10 minutes. That's cool. Let's go ahead and move this rest in place. Zip, 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 zip. All right, come here, you. Oh gosh. Oh no, that was not even. Rage. Table flip. Just kidding. Rage quit. I don't think Kud's ever rage quit anything. Ever. I take that back. I've probably rage quit something. Games are frustrating. Frustrating.
Bert, you just get better at them.
Come on. Why is this not? Ooh. Did you guys see a flash of light? Oh well. I can't see. It's too dark. Okay. Let's go do this real quick because I want to. Okay, that's a white light. I'm gonna make this a fluorescent light across the back and then light it up. All right. Let's just go right here. There we go. Oh, how far does it go? To right there, doesn't it? It's a short light. Finished. There we go. What I'll do is I'll outline this in white. And then we'll grab up some wires and hook it all together. There we go. It's gonna look so pretty. Come on, get in the corner. Finished. Oh, the lag. Did it really? Well, it looks like we're going to be lighting it up from the opposite end. That's okay. We can do that. Let's grab one of these wires. And we'll just go right here. Come on, code. Come on. Get on there. We'll attach it to the back side here. Okay. Zoom in. There we go. And then to here. And then down. Oh gosh. It's laggy. Finished. Yay. Wait. I don't have a switch. Why don't I have switches? Oh, I know why. I used it over here. There's my switch. Hello. Oh, no, I didn't mean to. Okay. Oh, that works. Grab you up. And this is just a temporary light, just so I have something to work with. Oh gosh, we're getting close on time. Okay. Turn. Oh. Rotate. Turn. Rotate. There we go. Come on, get on there. Uh-oh. Turn. There we go. Oh no, it's just short. Darn. There, move. You're coming with me. Right in the middle, good. Let's go straight up first, like that. And then we'll follow this path like we were before. Oh gosh. Is it gonna reach? Oh, it's gonna be short, isn't it? No, it's gonna be like, oh, it worked. Sweet. Finished. Yay! And then there's actually one there, so if I reloaded my base, it would turn out just fine. But we'll have fluorescent lights across here. That way we can have experimentations, like an actual fluorescent light above the thing. That's gonna look so cool. That is so cool. Okay, I think that's good for tonight. Oh no, let's do a couple more. Why not? So all those that just quit because they're like, oh, he's done. Click, and you switched off of it. I'm sure there's tons of like icons over there, or a whole bunch of thumbnails for like other suggested videos and awesomeness. And there's also some at the very end of this, so I don't know. I'm having fun. I'm building. Oh gosh, okay. I forgot, this one was off tilter. Hold on, get up there, dude. Get on the second floor. Why are you not on the rotate? Finished. All right. Oh, I don't have to click finish. All right, nice and easy. I want to do turn. And just slide into place. There you go. Perfect. That's exactly what I wanted you to do the first time. Why was it so easy this time and not last time? I don't understand. Is it because I'm standing on top now? Hold on. Let's go like that. Oh. Nope. It just jumps. Come on. Come on. Turn. And it worked. Turn it over. It seemed to fit. Move. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Nope. And turn. And it fits. Goes right in. That's so weird. I will not understand that. Why doing that little motion of turn corrects it. It fixes it. It's like, oh, now it's gonna work. All right. So we're just gonna have one whole gap here. And this is gonna go right there. That should be perfect. Yes. Right there on the edge. And we can fill that in later on, by the way. For now, I'm just trying to get the tiles that I've made in place. That way we can carry on. And I do apologize about it being a non-public server. This is my own personal private server, but I wanted to get a lot of stuff built tonight and just basically get away for a second, because I am about to do the 1 hour collabs with everybody. So this is basically just taking a nice break before the week begins. Well, I guess the week has begun for you guys, hasn't it? Okay, well, this is going to post throughout the week, but it's not yet. So I hope that makes sense. Let's go ahead and move this on in. This is going to be the last one. Last one, promise. And we'll just come across the top like this. And, oh gosh. Good. That's awesome. Amazing. Okay, so let's do a little bit of logic just while we're here. Oh wait, can I do it with an AND switch? I don't know that I can do it with AND switches, but I was going to try and show you guys how to make basically a flip-flop switch. No, that's not gonna work. It's gotta have an XOR. Do I have another inverted? I don't have another inverter. There's an OR switch. So the difference between an XOR and an OR is, with an OR, it says either the left or the right one can be on. With an XOR switch, here, I'll just do these real quick. Oh no, I can't. I gotta have switches. With an XOR, either the left or the right can be on, but not both. And they can't both be on or both be off. So it can only be like 1-0 or a 0-1, but not a 0-0 and not a 1-1. I don't know if that makes sense to you guys, but it will later on, because we are going to play with them. Absolutely. Okay, so I've got OR. We should definitely start lining these up. That's an AND, that's an XOR, and that's just an OR. So let's just move the regular OR switches right here. Rotate, rotate. Whoa, 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 come on. There we go, OR. And then, is that an AND switch? Move. Yeah, that's an AND switch. You just put it down there, code. Silly. Move. This is going to be amazing, by the way. Code Primate Labs. Moving stuff in place, building logic chips all over the place. I'm like really excited. I want to start now and I can't. I gotta wait. Is that another OR? OR. Yep. And what was this one? That one is just an OR. Just an OR switch. Which nothing is just anything. Oh, hang tight. What happened there? They're like out of line. You, sir, are out of line. Well, that's where it wants to go. Maybe that one's out of line. Yeah, there we go. Now they're lined up. I set it on top of the other one. And then XOR. Move. We'll have XOR switches right here. So it'll go AND OR XOR invert. Move. Invert. Basically, I'm just going to stack this back wall. These are all going to be like storage thingies. I can't remember what this is. This is signal delay and sustain. So let's move this one right there. Oops. Move. Rotate, rotate. And move right there. Okay, so we'll put sustain first and then delay. And we'll show you what the differences of those are as well. Wood detectors. I'll sort the rest out later. But for now, we have a nice little stack started. We're gonna fill up this back wall full of logic. And then I'll start making experiments out here. And then we'll come up here like this, make like a second floor of experiments. I'll have to have an easy way of transferring all this stuff upstairs though. We'll figure it out. It'll be fun. Thank you everyone for watching this episode of Lumber Tycoon 2 with me, Heath Haskins, Code Primate, building my laboratory and building some logic up. It's amazing. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. I love you guys very much. No pressure to actually go and subscribe. I always say that. If you want to, excellent. It helps me, it helps you, and don't forget to hit the notification thing, but that's just a call out that I'm supposed to do. So because YouTube says do a call out, I'm gonna go ahead and do a YouTube call out. So, call to action. Love you guys. Bye.